Hey everyone, today I'm going to answer a question that I've been getting a lot, and I'm going to answer it as simply as I understand it, as well as concisely as possible in this short video. So what is the difference between product design and user experience design? Now, there are usually two types of people who work in product. One is the innovator type, and then the other is the optimizer slash maintainer type. So the innovator type are the people who work on products 0 to 1, as in the product still hasn't found its product market fit. And the 1 to N people are people who work on mature or more mature products that have found its product market fit. Usually these products have also crossed the chasm, so to speak, and they've already been established in mature markets. Now the true nature of product design is more of an innovator type, because product design is a role that has been born out of startups, as in from the ground up, they're working with startups to find that product market fit, to find that there is a real need that the product is solving that A is going to result in explosive user growth, or B result in profitability that can sustain the business long term or short term if that is the goal. Because of this, product designers work very closely with product managers. In the book Inspired, it even talks about the fact that the first partner a product manager goes to is a product designer. So a product designer has to understand product strategy as well as user experience. However, their ultimate goal is not to make the feature as perfect and as seamless an user experience as possible. Rather, they're trying to determine that this problem they're solving, that they're designing for, is such an important problem that a product has to be made for it. So because product designers need to understand product strategy, their goal is not to create a feature as seamless as possible, but rather to make sure that the product is solving a real problem. A real problem that exists in the market for a product. If the product is solving a painful enough problem that users are motivated to take action on, users will even tolerate a mediocre experience. However, if the product is not solving a real problem, no matter how well it's designed, users and the marketplace will ultimately reject it and it cannot sustain as a business. Now, after this 0 to 1 stage, products go to 1 to N stage, meaning they have found product market fit and they are looking for optimizers to make the product as usable as possible. Typically, these are UX designers because of the fact that the goal of UX designers are to make the products as usable as possible. UX designer is an older title than that of product design as we know it today, which was coined by Facebook, and UX design is also more academic. In terms of product design as we know it for apps, only Stanford has a well-established undergrad as well as master's program specifically for product design in the country, as far as I know. Typically, product designers are more generalist than user experience designers. Again, this comes down to the fact that product designers have to focus on product strategy as well as user experience, while user experience designers just focus on user experience. Of course, user experience designers can also take on strategy. However, there's a reason why in startups in Silicon Valley, almost exclusively all design titles are product design. And again, that goes to the fact that they are in the 0 to 1 phase of looking for product market fit, hence why product designers, and with user experience designers, they're in the 1 to N phase, meaning they're working on products that have already found its product market fit. Product design is definitely more prominent on the West Coast, as in there's a lot more startups in the West Coast because of the nature of VC funds, entrepreneurship, etc. However, over the years, it seems like it's making a slow migration to the East Coast, which is predominantly UX design. A lot of companies now are starting to use the title product design, and I think this is because it attracts a lot of attention from candidates once they see that title. Typically, product designers have a lot more ownership in what they do, as well as higher pay. However, a lot of these companies do not necessarily understand what that means. I would say that product design also has a lot more ownership, and that means from the work and the company itself, because typically when you work in a startup, you are given equity as a product designer since you are there in the early stages. And because you own a part of the business, you are truly, truly understanding the meaning of ownership in your work. With UX designers, this is not the typical case as product design. They will get compensation in terms of salary and health insurance and other perks, but stocks are not a guarantee as much as a product design role. I hope this video helps anyone who is watching, and if you all have any questions, please comment below. Please like and subscribe to my YouTube channel. I'm almost at 10K, so any sub would be greatly appreciated. And I know this is a pretty brief video, but I can do a follow-up on more questions that you have. Again, this video is based on my experiences, so how I perceive product design and user experience design differently. Thank you all for watching to the end. I really appreciate it, and I'll see you all next week.